Hey guys, Sanjana here. Welcome back to my channel. Hope you guys are all doing really well. If you're new to my channel, thank you for watching today's video. I do a lot of study, career, finance, side hustles, productivity, organization type of videos. So if you're interested in any of that, then please do subscribe to my channel. Now, as you can tell by the title of today's video, this has been a very much requested video. I've received a lot of emails, DMs, people asking me, how is it that I manage my full-time 9-to-5 job along with my YouTube channel, which is my side hustle? So I wanted to just break it down for you guys and give you guys the lowdown on how I effectively manage my day-to-day work activities and my side hustle as well. So if you're interested, then please keep watching. Now, just to give you guys a little bit of context, so I have a full-time 9-to-5 job. I work at one of Australia's big four banks as a risk manager. I've been in this position for over a year and a half now, and yeah, it's a full-time job. I work about 40 hours a week, and along with that, I also obviously run my YouTube channel. Not only is this the only channel that I've got, I've actually got a second YouTube channel as well. So this channel, I obviously put out 2 videos a week without fail, and on my second channel, which is a fashion lifestyle vlogging channel, I put out 1 video a week. So all up, I'm putting out 3 videos a week along with my full-time job, and I've also got corresponding Instagram pages as well, which do tie up with the 2 YouTube channels. So I'm trying to post frequently on there as well. I do weekly Q&A sessions on my study, finance, career Instagram page. If you are interested in following any of the channels or my Instagram pages, then be sure to check the description box below for all of the links. So that's a little bit about what I'm doing on a weekly basis. And because you guys see that I'm always putting out content, I'm always, you know, online, social media, trying to sort of, you know, make my presence. A lot of you guys were very interested in knowing how I actually manage my full-time job and this YouTube side hustle as well. So I wanted to break it down for you guys. So I've got a list here in front of me, which I think really helped me in effectively managing my time, managing my priorities. And I think this is what's really helped me in making sure that I find that balance between the two. Now, starting off in no particular order, the first thing I like to start off by saying is that I prioritize and treat my side hustle as a full-time job. So I treat it as my second job, because I feel like I give my first job, which is obviously my bank job, I obviously give full 100% dedication and, you know, devotion to that. I feel like if I didn't put the same amount of effort and dedication to my full-time job into this side hustle, then the side hustle would eventually fail and it just wouldn't work. So I need to treat it like it is my second job. I need to be strict with it. I think that also comes down to my mindset, the mental strength, the discipline that I have in making sure that I treat this as my second job. And I really need to focus on this, because at the end of the day, like, how badly do you want it? How badly do you want to escape the rat race? So that's really how I approach it. I approach it as a bit of a business mindset. Like, this is something which is my escape, which could potentially turn into a business later down the track. So if I want that to grow, if I want to quit my job, if I want that financial freedom, I want that, you know, work-life balance, then I need to put all my effort into that as well. So yeah, I just treat the two very, very seriously. I'm very strict with my timelines, with my organization, and just how devoted and dedicated I am. I think, yeah, that's the first thing, the mindset and how well you prioritize your side hustles. So I think that's the first step in me being able to effectively manage my side hustle and my full-time job. The next thing that I do to manage my time well is to have a checklist. I've got a checklist, I've got a to-do list, I've got Google Calendar, I've got everything on my phone as well, my notes, and I swear by this because I feel like I need to stay organized and need to be on top of things to be able to know what is happening when. You guys will be surprised, but I honestly write everything on my to-do list. I have a daily to-do list, I have a weekly to-do list, I have a Google Calendar, which is for both of my YouTube channels, Success by Sanjana and by Sanjana as well, and those are synced up to my phone, so if there's a reminder, it would obviously show up on my phone as well, and that's how I keep organized. I have the Notes app on my iPhone as well, so if I'm ever out and about and I don't have a pen and paper to write things down, then I obviously jot it down in my notes, and then once I come home, I transfer that onto my weekly checklist. checklist or my daily checklist. I also have the app as well, which is called Todoist. It's basically an online to-do list, and I usually just keep this for the bigger picture things like, you know, business planning, personal growth, future development, things like that. I just keep a to-do list on there, which are sort of continuous and ongoing things that I need to manage and maintain. That could just be like, you know, YouTube ideas. So that also is synced to my phone and my desktop as well. But yeah, being on top of my checklist and my to-do list, I think, is something that's very, very important. I write the weekly checklist on a Sunday night, and I write my daily checklist the night before. So on Sunday, I'm writing two sets of to-do lists. I think this is very, very important, and I'm not a person that likes to have it on my phone per se. I like writing things. I like writing my thoughts on a piece of paper, and once I've done that, I like scratching it out, knowing that I've achieved that for the day. So yeah, I think having something where, you know, you don't want things to always just be sitting and lingering in your head. You want to jot it down on some piece of paper just so that you have a bit more clarity in your head. So yeah, that's something that I am very, very strict with, having a to-do list. Number three, now this comes to my work. I've been fortunate that my full-time job is not actually that demanding. And I would say in the last couple of months, because it's, you know, coming towards the end of the year, it's a new financial year, work has actually not been that demanding. In fact, it's been very, very flexible. The hours are amazing. I don't need to work long hours. So I'm very grateful, very thankful that my work isn't as demanding as I know a lot of you guys have jobs out there are. Because of that, I am also able to focus on my side hustle a little bit more. As you guys all know, we're working from home, so we've got a lot more time on our hands. I used to be spending 3 hours a day traveling, so I get that back. I absolutely love that. Don't need to, you know, get ready in the morning and, you know, get unready after work as well. So definitely saving a lot of time there, and I'm using all of that time as much as I've got to be able to manage everything to the best of my ability. So with those extra 4 hours, I would say, in the day, or even 5 hours that I've got back, including the get ready, unready, and the travel time, I'm using that time to plan my videos, plan the content, shoot the videos, edit, etc. So yeah, definitely that does help. But another thing that helps is that I actually stick to my work schedule. I'm only meant to be working 9 to 5, no longer than that. Of course, if there is a day, you know, where there's a deadline or there's something due, I would obviously put in the extra hours to get that done if need be. But if you've been on top of work since the beginning, you've been managing it well, you've been, you know, getting everything done, then there shouldn't be a reason for you to stay back after work. And that's what I've been doing. I've been working no longer than the 8 hours that's required of me. I stick to my schedule, start at 9, finish at 5:15, 5:30. And that's basically how I feel like I've got a lot of time back. I know it's hard with people working from home now. You feel like, you know, you're always, you know, glued to your laptop, but you need to really create those boundaries and really sort of, you know when to shut down and know when it's time to just clock off and just finish work off for the day, so you can focus on other things, because otherwise you're just going to be consumed with work and you're really not going to get anything else done. So I'm very strict with this. I don't like working more hours than usual, and I'm really all about that work-life balance. Moving on to the next one, and that is that I am very strict with my time. I am very, very weary that I've only got a little bit of time, so I try to make the most of it. And that also means if there is something going on, if I'm meant to visit, you know, friends or family or something that, you know, I need to do, I would actually reconsider doing that, because I feel that if I want to build something and I want something to grow on the side and work on my side hustle, then I need to give it my full attention. Of course, it's not like, you know, I'm not going to see my family for, you know, months on end. I definitely do still go and see them every second week. So, but what I'm trying to say is I'm not the person that always goes out, you know, every Friday night, every Saturday night for drinks. I'm not a party animal. In fact, I'm quite a homebody. So that really works in my favor as well. I like staying at home. I like being in my own space, doing my own things. And this obviously means I monitor, and I'm weary of the relationships around me as well in terms of my friends. So if there's anyone in my friendship groups that doesn't, you know, provide value or is negative, then I would just, you know, disassociate myself with that person, because I can't afford, you know, spending time or wasting time on that. So yeah, I pick my friends very wisely. I make sure that the friends around me are actually my genuine friends. I need it to feel like it's a two-way street. I can't be, you know, in friendships that I feel like I'm constantly giving and not getting anything in return. So for that reason, I have actually cut a lot of people out of my life in the last couple of years and months as well. well. So yeah, just being very strict with my time, making sure that I stick to my schedule and stick to my planner, otherwise I won't get things done. And if that means also, you know, no Netflix, no binge watching TV shows, then I will do that because I would rather focus on something that is essentially gonna allow me to, you know, be financially free, be free from work and do things on my own accord. I'm willing to do anything to, you know, make that happen. So yeah, no Netflix for me. But this also doesn't mean that I don't enjoy my time as well. I try to find that balance. I'm always, you know, up to date on TV shows as well. Whenever I'm having lunch, I watch a TV show, but as soon as I finish my lunch or dinner, then I stop watching and then I get on to, you know, doing whatever it is that I need to. Obviously on the weekend, you know, spend a few hours just lazing around as well and just making sure that I'm not, you know, burnt out, I'm not constantly working. So yeah, that's definitely another thing to note. Another thing is that I love multitasking. I love being able to do a few things at the same time so that I can kill two birds with one stone. So what I mean by this is because I don't get a lot of, you know, downtime, I don't get time to just, you know, just read, reflect, listen to audio books or podcasts. I like doing this during times where I'm doing, you know, the mundane household chores. For example, doing the laundry, I would listen to an audio book, a podcast, and I'll listen to things that would actually motivate me and really get me G'd, because I think in terms of what I'm doing, I do need that motivation, because sometimes I do lose that motivation. So I do need that little pick me up to get me going again. So yeah, even when I'm washing the dishes, you know, mopping around the house or whatever it is, I do want to do something in that time. I don't just want to be mopping. I want to be either, you know, listening to a book, a podcast, especially Gary Vee. He's a really good motivator. And just really being efficient with my time, because I think I don't like wasting time and I don't like doing, you know, simple household chores. I get bored. So I feel like this is a good way for me to really, you know, educate myself as well while getting, you know, household chores done as well. And the last one that I want to mention, how I effectively manage my YouTube channel, which is my side hustle, and my 9-to-5 job, is that this year I have actually started taking care of my mental and physical health. And this is something that I didn't actually prioritize, you know, in the past years, and I had actually neglected my physical health, and I could obviously see that that was taking a toll on me. So this year I decided to, you know, go to the gym and really work out, take care of myself, eat, you know, fresh fruit and vegetables, maintain a healthy diet, getting all of my, you know, my physio and massages, things like that, all of that done, just so that I don't feel burnt out. I'm still taking the time out to take care of myself, because what's the point of working long hours, working hard, when you can't even take care of your health? Because I feel like that's the most important thing. What's the point of hustling when your health isn't on top? So I definitely consider health and well-being to be my number one priority, and I make sure that all things on that aspect and all things on that front are up to date and I'm healthy and I'm well. Only then am I able to effectively manage my full-time job and my YouTube channel as well. So yeah, definitely have been making that a priority this year, and I've noticed the biggest difference. I've obviously got more energy, more time, I'm feeling more lively, the food that I'm eating is healthier, so I'm definitely seeing the benefits with that. So yeah, that is everything, and that's how I manage my 9-to-5 job and my side hustle. If there's anything that you guys do that's different to me, I would love to know. If I've missed anything that can help me out or anyone else in the community, then definitely leave a comment down below. I would love to know. And if you don't already follow me on my Instagram and my second YouTube channel, then be sure to click the links in the description box. I'll leave all the information there. But other than that, guys, I will catch you guys in my next video. Thanks, guys.